sense of monstrous guilt was upon the land, and out of the abysses between the stars swept chill currents that made men shiver in dark and lonely places. He had had an unprecedented dream of great cyclopean cities of titan blocks and sky-flung monoliths, all dripping with green ooze and sinister with latent horror. And everyone felt that the world, and perhaps the universe, had passed from the control of known gods or forces to that of gods or forces which were unknown. The thing cannot be described. There is no language for such abysms of shrieking and immemorial lunacy, such eldritch contradictions of all matter, force, and cosmic order. In his house at Arlien, dead Cthulhu waits, dreaming.
I'm finally beginning to grasp it all. His writings are full of parallels with metaphysical writings throughout the ages.
Evie, Lovecraft was a pulp writer from the 20s.
He writes of the great old ones, etheric beings from beyond the stars. They lie dormant and speak to men in dreams. To glimpse them is to go mad.
Evie, I'm starting to worry.
One day, they will awaken. It'll be the end of the world.
I think you should step back from this.
There are parallels to the Zoroastrians.
I don't think it's good for you.
They believed in the demiurge, a demon that created the earth.
Just for a little while.
And the Norse idea of Ragnarok.
Evie.
When the great wolf Fenris will devour the sun.
Evie. I think you need some time. With what happened to your parents and the other thing.
No, my dissertation.
Evie, you need to be with people. You need to be with your friends.
I have to go.
Evie.
Thank you.
Is anyone there? Someone there? Where are you? I can't hear you. Is anyone there? Hello? Please say something.
Hello?
Is anyone there? I can't hear you.
Hello?
Is anyone there?
Where are you?
Is anyone there? Please say something.
Say something.
I can't find you. Where are you?
Where are you?